Skool.com is one of the easiest options out there when it comes to creating an online community. You could also host courses there. So let me show you exactly how to get started with Skool.com with your own accounts and create yourself an online community with courses. This is Skool.com. I'll put a link in the description if you want to sign up from that. And you could go ahead and create yourself a community just from this tab right here, or you could press this drop down right here and create a community. What's nice about Skool is other people could also discover your community this way too. So this is a search tool if you want to search for different type of communities, and they have category-based communities that you could explore here too. Now, for creating a Skool account, very straightforward. This page and the next page is going to ask you to put in a credit card and start a 14-day free trial. Skool is actually $99 a month after the trial ends. So if you want to host your community with courses and things like that, that's going to cost you $99 a month. But you have a 14-day free trial to make sure it's a good fit, and then you could cancel within that and not get charged. Okay, so I created myself a community here, very straightforward process, and it's gonna bring you to this page. So here inside of your school's homepage, let me show you exactly what you're looking at. On the very top, you have these different tabs, and Skool is basically three different things. It's a community, so all the posts when people post here that are part of your community, they're gonna show up all down here. Then you have classrooms. Here is where you could basically make courses. I'll show you this in a little bit. And then you also have calendar, so you could show events that are coming out in calendar format. And then these other ones will show your members here. And then they have a leaderboard here. Basically, they gamify the membership so people actually use it more often. And then here you have your About Us section. I'm gonna show you how to customize all that. So from this page, the very first thing I recommend you do is actually go to the settings tab right here. Under dashboard, you could set up a community that is completely free. And then you could also set a community that you charge people for. And then if you do charge people, your paying members will show over here. And this is your monthly recurring revenue. So let's say you charge $10 a month, you have 5 members, that's gonna show $50 a month in recurring revenue that will show up over here. Then under payouts, they basically take care of all kinds of things in the back end, so you don't have to worry about setting up a payment processor or any of that. They just basically pay you every 7 days on whatever balance shows up over here. You could go ahead and invite people to your group right here. So they have an invite link. You just copy that and share that on social media or videos you're gonna make. Under the general tab, here's where you would customize everything. So you wanna add an icon, you wanna add a cover letter, you could name your group over here, and you could make sure you change your group to private if you're gonna charge for that group, or you could go ahead and just leave it public and anybody's gonna be able to see that. So they're gonna see the group, they're gonna see what people are posting, and it's gonna be discoverable by search engine. So this is up to you which one you wanna choose. Now under subscription, every time you create a Skool community like this, a Skool account, it's just gonna have one tier, which is a free tier. So anybody joining this community could do it completely for free. But what you could do is you could add another one here. Now, if you do that, you do have to connect a bank account, and it says Skool uses Stripe to send payments to your bank account. So it looks like you don't have to set up a Stripe account, which is nice. That could get kind of complicated. Skool takes care of that for you, but they do actually need to pay you. So that's the process there, very straightforward on the steps after that. So you also have categories. So let me exit here. Under the community tab, you see it says general discussion. So there's the all tab and there's a general discussion tab. But you could have more tabs over here depending on different topics that you want to talk about. So you could go ahead and add another tab here and then give it a name, give it a description, and then make sure the permission is set to whatever you want. And then when you add it, if I exit here, you could see if I refresh the page, I have a new tab over here, and people's discussion will just be filtered through that, kind of to organize your community a little bit better. And then under tabs, basically I have classroom turned on. If you turn it off, this classroom tab goes away. So if you just want to have a community without any courses, you could do that. You could just turn that off. And if you don't want to use the calendar option, that one could also be turned off. Now, plugins you don't have to really worry about, but if you're doing more advanced things like Zapier integrations, lets you do some automations. But for the most part, you don't have to turn any of these on. Metrics is really nice. It's basically analytics, everything with total members, active members, the daily activity, everything's going to show up over here. And as I mentioned, this is gamification. So basically, you could get people to go through different levels, and then that will encourage them to consume more of your content, more of your courses, be more engaged. So you could set up those different levels here and exactly what people need to do to unlock that level. So this is really nice. Or you could leave it here on default. Right now, I don't have any courses, to set up anything else. Now, because Skool is a platform with all communities hosted in the same place, you could get discovered, but that's gonna require you to actually complete your setup and meet some requirements. Then you have links over here. So if you wanna share links with people that are on a different website, different URL, and if they're private or public, you could go ahead and set that over here, and then you could add those. And let me exit here. So that's basically everything that's in their settings that you need to set up to make sure everything on your account is ready to go. Once that is ready to go, it's gonna give you some steps. So it says invite three people, add a group description, add a cover, and write your first post. So to write a post, all you have to do is just tap over here, and this is gonna let you type a post, and you could say, welcome to my community, and tell people exactly what you want them to know as your very first post. And then you could see it has a bunch of different options under each post. So you could add YouTube videos, you could add all kinds of different links and attachments. And then when you go ahead and post it, it's going to show up on their community. And what's nice is you could send, if you have members, you could actually send them an email too, or not. That's a great way to encourage people to come back to this if they need to come back to this. I did not give it a title. Let me give it a title here and post it. And there we go. So it's going to show up over here, and anybody could come and interact with it. They could leave comments here. And I'm going to show you the Skool community in a second. So when a community is fully populated, you'll see kind of what it looks like. Then under classroom, if you want to make a course, all you have to do is press new course. And then your first course is going to be named here, your course description. And with permission, you could let all your members have access, some members, or this one is based on levels. So if you're gonna gamify it and let people go through levels, you could lock courses based on that. Here's where your cover is gonna go. So I'll just add a temporary one here. And here's a cover I've made for a course I have. I'm gonna save that. I'll rename the course. I'll press add, and I'm gonna make sure it's set to publish over here. Okay, now you have your course created. Now you have to make different videos within that course, and it's really simple to do that. All you have to do is press this pencil icon. It already creates one page for you. And here you could type in the first course, so introduction. That's gonna be the name of this lesson. And then you could go ahead and add a YouTube video. So you could choose this option here and add a link. Or you could host your videos. If you don't want to put them on YouTube, you could also put them on Vimeo or any of these other websites like Loom or Wistia. So I added a YouTube link here. So my title is going to go here. My YouTube video is going to look like this. I could add more underneath it. So I could add any kinds of descriptions that I want underneath it. You have all kinds of different formatting options available too. You could add images here. You could go ahead and add links to any other website here with a URL link. You could have the little separators here to organize this page. And then down here, if you want to add anything like a resource link, you could add your transcription here. You could add it as a post here. Very useful option, but very simple at the same time. So in this case, I'm going to upload a file, which is a PDF, and I'll go ahead and label this resource. Add that. Okay, and it's going to show up just like this. Let me go ahead and save it now. And now we have one video inside of this big course. And then within that, anybody could press play to watch the video, and then it could go ahead and download the PDF resource, and anything else I add, I could always go ahead and edit it. Now, when someone watches this video, they could press the check mark, and then it's gonna show this is 100% complete because I only have one, so the course is gonna look like it's 100% complete. But I need to add another page, so I could click here. I could also organize it based on folders, but in this case, I'm just gonna add another page, and then I could edit this. This is gonna become video 1.2 prompting. Okay, and I'll go ahead and save this. And then the same thing that I did with the first one, I would edit it, I would add a video. Sometimes you could just add text if you don't have a video with links or resources. And then if you wanna organize it a little bit more, go ahead and add a folder. So this is gonna be section one. I'll go ahead and save that. And then I'll grab these and put them underneath section one to make it nice and organized. So you could kind of order things this way. So now if someone watches this and marks it as done, 50%, because now we have a second video. And then if you only have one course, it's gonna look like this. When someone jumps in there, it's gonna look like this. But if you had another course, it's gonna show up right next to it, and you could have multiple courses here within your community. Okay, now let me show you, if you press this drop down, you could actually join other communities. It's gonna say create a new community, but every time you create one, it's another subscription. Again, you have that free trial, but within one membership, you get one community that you could make, and you could discover communities. Now, I joined a Skool community to show you what it looks like when a community is fully populated. This has about 100,000 members. So the community tab, you could see there's a bunch of different things here, a bunch of different tabs that you could explore. And then within the classroom tab, you have a bunch of different courses. So they have one called Skool 101, which actually the creator shows you exactly how to use the different parts of this platform, kind of step by step. And then you have the members. So all the members are gonna actually show up over here. You have the leaderboard to gamify it. So as you can see, it gets a lot more interesting when you have a lot of members. The About Us section, once you add the picture and you add your introduction here, it's gonna look a lot more professional. But most of the activity is gonna take place between the community tab, the classroom tab. They have the calendar tab in this case turned off. And then you can see the members and the leaderboards here. Very straightforward on setting this up from scratch to host a community and online courses. So again, if you want to sign up and try this for yourself, I have a link in the description below this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.